to register and verify yourself, which will take you to the site, and then you can add additional entities, or at this point you can add multiples as well if you want. So it's completely up to you. But just to show you, you're gonna go add, you can start typing in any or which characters of the name. I'm gonna just see if we don't really have a name. Do you maybe have a name of the company I can assume, so just to bring up the list?
ABC and XYZ.
Okay, so as an example, I just typed in K for K-Man. Obviously, what you want to do is search for your company name, select this section over here is obviously production, so select whichever one your company would be, which will then add. Obviously, you want to go all the way, so I'll just click it for now just to show you what will happen. It will add it in there. You can then at this point click add again, add the second entity, and keep on going, you know, until you obviously have all of them, or you can just do one at this point and register, and then you can add it in later on as well. Okay? So once you've filled out and completed all of that.
When Mr. Dixon was talking, he said you could either be an owner, director, or officer. Mm-hmm. Here it's just saying if you're an owner. So if you're an owner of a company, and then you're an officer, you've got to go around and do this twice, do you?
No, this one. So it's
so it doesn't matter. It says owner, but it doesn't mean owner.
Yes.
It could be owner, officer, director.
Yes, correct, yeah.
Okay.
100%. Okay. So you just want to register over here. This process will happen. Obviously, you'll send a verification to ROC directly. They'll go and verify the information or whatever you've provided is obviously on their records. And as soon as that's done, you'll be able to log into the site. Okay. So I'm going to jump. So maybe first, any questions on this before I go ahead? Pretty straightforward.
I have registered my company.
Mm-hmm.
And if you go by the top and you enter the picture and all of that for
mm-hmm.
the new coming down,
mm-hmm.
you can't select add if the company has not been registered. So when you click the registered button, it carries you back to a screen where you add the company, where it goes to business and people, then you go back to the add.
How long ago did you do your registration?
Saturday.
Okay, maybe if you want to come past, we can just check it here.
It's good because I've got the verification. I have email with me to show that it was done. It's just that I'm just saying on there that you're doing. If the person is new,
mm-hmm.
you would not find their name in the listing.
Yeah.
You would have to register, then you add the name.
Yeah, I mean yes. the company.
The company, right.
Yeah.
If they're new to the site, you won't find it there. Because I was there for a little while, clicking the add to add mine. And that's where I discovered that I can't find it because I'm new to the site.
It just takes
so
time.
Right, so I click register,
uh-huh.
then it carries me to a screen where I add the business, add the individuals, then submit, then I go back to, it takes me back to that add button.
Yeah, so that if you're truly a new user,
you won't be able to find
it. It takes the system a few minutes to a half hour
right. you won't
to create you before it creates
yeah, yes.
you and verifies you to
yes, 100%, because obviously they need to check on the back end
yes.
to make sure. So it will
yeah.
take you to the
right.
site, you can't do anything until they've obviously approved that, then the site will come live, which I'll show to you. Obviously, I'll show you in 1 second. Okay. Okay, so obviously, go through the four steps. Register yourself, that will send the verification to ROC. They'll then at that point, like you said, you can't really do any filings at that point until they verified it. But as soon as they've verified it, you'll get to look similar to this one. So if it's not verified, really easy to see. You'll notice that this section over here where you select your actual entity, that will just be grayed out. That won't be there until it's obviously authorized from the ROC sort of point of view. Okay?
Mm-hmm.
So let's just pretend we've obviously registered, ROC has approved your verification, you are the owner of the company. Just to obviously go ahead. So I'm just jumping, you'll see it says QA CDP. So this is our QA site or our demo site, just for now, so don't get confused. You obviously want to work on cdp.secure.ky. But once you're in the site and you've been verified, really easy, the way we've done it, dashboard right on top, people in business and documents received. The dashboard is where you can do all your filings and also see all the filings that you have done. Okay, and I'll show you guys a little bit of information on that. People in business, which again we'll get to, is where you'll... Oh, sorry. Is this idle for too long? People in business is where you'll obviously add all the directors or shareholders, beneficial owners. All of that information will be done on that section. And then the documents received is all the documents, if you do maybe a certificate of good standing, once it's been approved, that will go into that folder in the website. Okay, everybody with me?
Mm-hmm.
Okay, So maybe this is to, and I'll try to show some of them. Maybe there won't be enough time to go through all of them, but it's really easy if you want to do a new filing. Only thing you need to do is select your entity. If you have multiple entities, you'll be able to select almost on the drop down all the different entities. If at registration sort of point of view, you only selected one entity, but you have multiple entities that you want to add on later on, you will notice on the side here on the right-hand side, there's add entity now. So you can just click on that, and it will take you to the same place where you can search for the second entity or third company that you might have. That will get obviously verified by ROC, and that's how that list will get populated on what you can select. Okay, so as an example, let's just use maybe a certificate request, one of the easy ones. We only have one company in this test environment. We'll select the company, and then on the services sort of side, you can select what sort of filing you want to do. Okay, easy one is request certificates. We'll select that, and then select new service request. Okay, regular express. Obviously, express is a little bit more expensive. It will show you the entity that you've obviously selected that you're working on, and then it will show you what certificate obviously you want to try and order. Again, this is this demo, so we've got not everything is in it.
So certificates, when you request regulars, you get back in 8 hours. You request express, you get it back in 4 minutes.
$100
for
it. So currently on the demo side we have over here, and we are working on the escrow accounts, but currently on the sites, if you do a certificate request right now, we always see currently accept credit cards. So this, as an example, we'll do a regular, we'll do maybe a certificate of incorporation, a little bit of payment information. Obviously, just recommend that you maybe have a read on it. But simple as this, going purchase now, which at this point you can just put on your credit details, pay now, and that obviously will send the filing through to ours.
Will that information be saved?
So not repeated? No.
We have repeated every time?
Yes.
Okay.
Yeah. So it will give you obviously the cost if it was express, like Ms. Flossie was saying, extra $100 just to do that. Okay? So I'm not obviously going to fill that out.
Transaction fee of $100.
No,
$1. But I thought it was free.
No, it's
$1. No, beneficial ownership is free, which I'll show you now. On that one, you don't have to pay.
Okay.
Yeah.
I mean,
they always have to pay for your certificate.
No, I mean, the $125 I know you have to pay for. Is the dollar below? Okay.
Okay. If you went there and spent the gas, you wouldn't have to pay a transaction fee. Spend the dollar in.
Okay.
Spend more than a dollar there.
So maybe just to show you guys, so if we look at one of these over here, that's where I did a certificate request. The dashboard itself is where it will show you the status of the filing. So if you've obviously just submitted the filing, it will go into pending mode, meaning that you're waiting on RSC for it to be approved. Once they've approved it, you will notice it will change to like one of these that says completed, meaning that it's been completed. At that stage, you can then immediately go to the documents received, and you'll be able to obviously see all the different documents and click on it to download it, and obviously print it out or save it or whatever you want to do. These documents will stay in the portal as long as the portal are here. You can't delete it or anything, so and you don't have to pay to go click on it again, so it's there for your own sort of benefits later on.
The escrow accounts, when it's set up, will be showing your balance and all that.
I would imagine it's not at that stage yet. It'd be more for Mr. Dottie, but that's the idea, yes.
And you'll be able to top it up through a credit card as well.
I would imagine, yeah. Okay, so maybe this, if everybody's okay, I'll just show the other sort of filing quickly as well. Again, we'll just use the same company. Let's maybe do the beneficial ownership one. We'll create a new service again, exactly the same way. And then over here, we will obviously see the entity you've selected, and then you'll be able to add all the shareholders. We are actually changing this to display beneficial ownership, not shareholders. It's a little bit confusing. Again, this is the demo, but that's changing very soon to this to show beneficial ownership.
So is there a date by which we should not start this for loading? If you're saying it's, can we load beneficial ownership even though it says shareholder?
Yeah.
Okay, you'll make that change internally and we don't have to worry about it.
Right.
Okay.
Yeah.
So,
sorry?
At the moment, we have to list all shareholders to get 100%.
Yeah, that's what we're changing. That's exactly, so,
because I was going to ask, what do you do about shareholders that are held by estates or untraceable shareholders?
So that's really why, and I'll maybe ask Mr. Donnie when he gets back to speak on that, but he is, my understanding, I think in the next week that will change, that it's only, and the shareholder sort of side will go completely out. The shareholder percentages, we have to show it when we need it.
So what will you actually enter?
So I'll show you, so it will be obviously, at this beneficial ownership, you'll obviously go add and add all the beneficial owners for that specific entity.
At the moment it's asking for all shareholders.
Yes, that's what I'm saying. That's
and that's
changing
going to
it.
Change.
Yes, to just the beneficial owners. Yeah, just to make it.
I will stop.
Yeah, but you don't have to add the shareholders. Even currently, if you want to do it right now, you only need to do the. Yeah.
Do the what,
sir? The 25%, the beneficial owners.
And if there are none who are 25%, how do you file your beneficial register if none of them are over 25%?
Yeah, then and if it's not a joint,
then
that would be.
For all your shareholders, and it shows the percentages, but if none are over 25%, then how do you file a beneficial register?
Yeah, so again, yeah, I'll have to ask
the 5%.
I have to know two people that I haven't had any.
Maybe let's just ask Mr. Donnie when he gets back, he's
more
honest.
The gentleman caller just said it, that if you have less than 25%, then you select.
An
individual who would be the person responsible, and if not, you form somebody to do something.
Yeah, but I'll just let him rather answer. That's not my sort of side of the business, so I'm not the right person to answer that.
Well, I was just explaining.
There should be a box to tick that there is no beneficial owners.
That's a fix that's coming up in next week, by next week.
So maybe just before I go ahead, I just want to show you guys just how to add obviously all the beneficial owners or shareholders or directors for that matter, just before we obviously click add even on here. So like I mentioned on top, there's people in business section. So if you go to people in business, over here is where you'll add all the beneficial owners or shareholders or all the contact information. We call it contacts, but all the information for them. So I currently obviously when you create a company, it will have the company. I've just created two extra persons just as just for the demo sort of purposes, but really easy. You can just click on if it's a business, click add a business. If it's a person, or we should add a person, add the person, and then just add all the information, complete all the boxes. The same sort of thing that you want to do is family name, nationality, birth and date. Just complete all of these fields. Once you've created the person, and I'll jump to one of them. Once you've created the person, obviously the information will be on top that you created. You can obviously edit and add any information on top of that. You want to then go down and just complete all the information that's needed. So obviously we've created the person. Second thing you want to do is do the identification, which again is over here. We can go add passport, driver's license, any of those type of things that you want to use. And then you want to obviously add an address as well.
Is there a requirement to put information, documents, upload documents for the person?
Yes, I think you have to, otherwise you can't, it's not going to allow you to file the beneficial owners. Okay, so you'll do that, obviously in people in business, make sure you add all the individuals that need to be in there, all companies, add the identification to each one, make sure that's there. Once you have all of that, you can obviously then go back to your beneficial ownership filing, to go back in here, and then click add and go search. You'll be able to find all the different people. So as an example, we'll just select myself, and then it's as simple as just clicking the drop down and selecting the information that you've always already put in the system. Okay?
If a person, let's say there's an owner of two companies, but that person is not signed up to have both of those companies, the director has signed up and have two different people and therefore have two different IDs. But that owner is already listed under one of the companies and loaded into the system. Will the director of the second company be able to find that person and add them as opposed to having to type all the stuff in and get their IDs and all?
Only if it's under the same sort of profile, if I call it the same profile. So if I registered into the CDP system and I was a director and I added both those entities into my management of my portal, then yes, those contacts
okay,
or directors.
They're in separate managements.
That's completely
okay.
Separate, yeah.
All right, thank you.
Yeah. Any other questions on that just before I go ahead. Okay, so obviously you want to complete all information, click apply, and then obviously select the second, or if there's more sort of beneficial owner services, obviously continue adding all the people into it. And then you can either save a filing if you'd want to, saving meaning it'll just go back to the dashboard until you may be ready to, maybe you don't have all the information, or maybe you're not ready to do it as yet, or else you can obviously submit it. Okay. Like we said, there's no fee on the beneficial ownership, so you'll notice you can just click submit, there's no credit card details or any of that sort of information needed.
How can you update, any of the beneficial owners change it?
So the first thing, if it's a contact, you want to go to your people in business,
mm-hmm.
okay, and go to your contacts. If it's a new one, add a new one. If it's maybe I got married, or a lady got married, surname changed, or middle, or whatever it might be, just go into the contact like I did, just enter it, click on the contact itself, and then obviously go to whatever might, maybe add a new address or whatever it might be.
Okay. So what about, how would you take one off of it? Or will you stay there?
The contact will stay in the system. I mean, you have it. There's a choice if you ever want to. If that contact is not used, so say maybe you created a contact and by accident and it shouldn't be there, you can delete contacts, but obviously if that is a contact that's used somewhere, then don't delete it. Otherwise, if you're not sure, rather just leave it in the system. Better just to have it there than deleting something if it's used.
Okay. Mm-hmm. And when the company is sold or shares transferred or something.
So these contacts are your contacts that you created, so they'll always stay in your profile. Obviously, if it's been moved or sold or whatever it might be, then that stays obviously up to you, I imagine, if you want to delete the contacts. So
I think the question is if there's a change in shareholding.
Yeah.
How do you remove one shareholder and put a new one? Will you go to the same filing of shareholding?
Yeah.
There's an end date for that.
Yeah.
You would do a new filing. You just basically create a new filing, and you can then add the end date.
You have already filed
it. Yeah. So once you've done a filing, sorry, I'm Sarah, I'm part of the CVP support team, not just a random human sitting at the back. You would then, once you've submitted your initial filing, right, and it's been approved by ROC, if there are changes to your shareholders, you would just create a new filing in which you can resign or change their shareholder numbers, or add a new shareholder, and then you file that.
Okay.
If some of your ID expires during the year, do you have to do anything, or you just do it next year?
I would imagine when you do the next filing, you'll just need to make sure
that your driver's license expires halfway through the year, it's not a problem.
Yeah, unless you obviously want to do a new filing. Yeah. Okay, any other questions on that? Okay, so the last one I'll just show you guys, because it's the annual return, obviously it's very similar, but again, select your entity you want to work on, annual returns, and then you go your new request, which will open up the form. This should obviously, I guess, be a bit familiar to you guys. That's normally doing it, the simple as selecting the year that you want to do it for. It'll show you on the right hand side a fee for that year. General information about yourself, obviously the person that's doing the filing, email address, name of the person making the declaration, addresses on the right hand side, positions, shareholder state, meeting, this information regarding obviously the company itself, location. It will also, as you create this whole document, you'll notice down here there's a preview, so you can click it in a preview, obviously how your annual return will actually look, just to show you before you obviously submit it. Down here, you obviously select your being annual return as shareholders. So from here, obviously, exactly the same sort of method. Make sure you've added the people to the people in business. Once they're in there, you'll be able to click add. And again, this search for the individual company for that matter. Select it. And again, just make sure you select the information, amount of shares they have, what sort of rights they might have, and on the company itself. And if there's director and officers, exactly the same. Make sure those director and officers have been created. You want, again, exactly the same way, click add, go find them in your list of people that you've created or companies. So make sure you've done that. And then just at the bottom here is the share capital sort of details, which you want to go through. The share capital information, obviously the currency that it's at. the number of shares put in the par value for you, amount of shares taken to date, amount of calls received, uploaded, and then we see number of shares forfeited, if any. And then at the bottom over here, which I think is maybe to one of your questions, if there's any people that's no longer a director officer, you know, we should down here, you can select them and add them before you wish you're going. Okay, and then again, at any point you can save this. If you save, maybe just to show you guys, if you save a document or a filing in the system, it will show you the changes has been saved. You can then use the return to previous or just go to your dashboard, and you will notice it will then put that filing, the one we just did, into preparing mode. So if ever you see preparing mode, it's just basically meaning you've created it, you haven't submitted it as yet, it's still for you to go back. So as simple as going back, clicking on that, and then just obviously adding in or changing, make, you know, do whatever changes you would need, and then obviously submit and pay at the bottom. This currently, obviously, again, is credit card, so we go submit now, we'll give you a chance to pay by credit card information.
So most of those fields said optional.
Yeah, this is a test environment.
Yes.
But it's the ones that are in production, you will see there's a red asterisk.
So again, once you've obviously done your filings and it's been approved by government's sort of side, maybe just to highlight again, just make sure you obviously go back and recite, double check if it says completed, make sure to go to your documents received, and then obviously from here you can, like I mentioned, download it. I can maybe see if I can try and see download if I can download one quick. Okay, so this as an example again, this is this demo at their site, so just to give you an idea. From here you can obviously download it to your machine or print it out or do whatever you need to do on your side. And that's I think that's really it at this point. I mean, like we said, we obviously an ROC are there to help, so please feel free to come by. You know, a lot of our sort of staff members, myself and Sara as well, you guys might see Sara as well, do help out on the site. But you know, don't, if it's overwhelmed or you're not sure, you know, by all means come in and we'll sit with you and go through it with you and make sure you get signed up, do a filing with you as well, get it, you know, verify it, and all that sort of information. Just try and make it a little bit easier for you. Any questions? Any other questions, maybe?
Okay, Doug. Again, thank you all very much for coming, and I hope that it was a benefit. And just please remember that that we're there, and we certainly want to help you get this thing done. So you got the after hours, you got the appointment choice, or you can try going it alone and still call us. We'll still help you. So either way, we'll get you on. So again, thanks very much, and let us know if we can help you in any way.
Thank you very much.